thank you very much for this debate we have after years giving us opportunity to meet again. It was 2004 we received Alexander Award, the year when Poland, Czech, Slovaks, Hungarians entered the European Union. And now we live in different Europe. And now we even can think about not only Brit exit, but also Pol exit. Yes, and we can raise questions about that. It was time 2004 for us in Poland, in borderlands, that we saw our reality from two perspectives. I think one was very progressive, that the good future is before us, that year by year we are on the good track to development, to emancipation, to democracy, and so on. But there was also another perspective we had. I mean, we, Bosnian generation, that's how I call the people who were involved in former Yugoslavia wars, and we understood at that time that it is not a marginal European war what is going on in former Yugoslavia, but it is in heart of reality we will face sooner or later in London, in Barcelona, in Berlin, in Warsaw, and so on. And now we saw there was a lot of anticipation at that time, which we now face fulfilled in Europe, and we always ask ourselves why it happens like that, and why we don't have this self-confidence and awareness about to prevent or to be stronger in struggling these things. And I would say at that moment, also 2004 for us, everything was post. You know, it was post-Holocaust, Central Europe, Central Eastern, post-totalitarian, Central Eastern Europe, even post-modern. My feeling today is that we are before something. And it makes a really deep change for to think about ourselves. We before something which is very uncertain, before something which comes and we don't understand fully how and why, and we should engage our work with not as we started with borderland, you know, of solving the memories, the past conflicts, the problems for the from the past. Of course, it helps also to face reality today, but to mobilize all our powers and efforts to face what, or to understand and to predict what is coming, what is before. So if I would compare this, you know, situation from the time we received Alexander Langer Award and today, we are shifting much more toward what is going to happen, what is before us. So we have this way, you know, as our discussion started, we started from the borderline and we now in the borderland. Yes, and all this, well, this is all our work is about, you know, to go from that situation of deep divisions, conflict, differences. Borderland is something, you know, what embraced borders. It makes borders internal, in fact. And because of that, the external border is weaker, is transparent. Is mobile, yes, but the challenge to gain this competence to live together inside with borders, to gain this craft of bridging, of living together, coexist with the others, I think is becoming more and more a challenge for us. So the workshop we established on this threshold of 1989, which we called Borderland, with different studios, is very much focused now more and more on this craft because it's not, of course, about erasing borders. It's very much about living together with them and crossing them on the daily basis. And to be very short, if I would use the metaphor for that situation, I would bring the discussion we had not long ago, 2 months ago. I was participating in the Green Convention of Europe in Utrecht, and we were discussing the borders issues and immigrant issues in Europe. And the project came to the table from Berlin about new effort Europe is doing today, thinking about building a bridge between Africa and Europe, the Mediterranean bridge. You can see even it in the internet now as a projection. My question is, and it's also, I think, for our tomorrow discussion, what is so in Europe that we are so eager and ready to invest billions of euros and to develop, you know, the technology, the material things to build a physical bridge across Mediterranean, which is okay, and it will be a splendid thing for our technological modernity, modern civilization. But why is so? What is about us, Europe, that we have a problem to understand that we need the same billions of Europe for building invisible bridges, for building something what is on the local ground between people level, to develop skills and competence on something what is, you know, on the community level and between the people. If you will go to Mostar, which is, you know, the city of the bridge, as you know, it was destroyed, or as Mostarians used to say, killed, because they don't say about the bridge as a thing, they say about human being. So when the bridge was killed, we all know that it is reconstructed, yes? And it is under the UNESCO protection and international community help to rebuild the bridge. But ask Mostarians, if they do have a bridge, they will say no. There is no invisible bridge yet built. And all the work we do, in fact, is about the second factor, about this what is invisible. Very much like in my lovely novel I love very much by Italo Calvino about invisible cities. Yes, well, if you remember this story of Marco Polo about the cities he was visiting to Kublai Khan, yes, reporting, it was a little about urbanistic physical things. It was very much about emotions, memories, human relations, smells, and everything what is invisible. So, in general, the whole work we do, you know, is, we even recently built for the first time our own invisible bridge on our borderland with the participation of people from Uganda, from Colombia, from Caucasus, different bridge builders we brought together to build a village of bridge builders and to think about how we can work on invisible bridge, how to gain the competence for such kind of work, which is community-based work, and we should engage all the people living around, because this is a thing you can't bring from, you know, from outside, yes, to the community. You should do it together with people, with all people. As I'm an artist, I'm a theater director, but I know that the craft of theater director or conductor of orchestra is totally different from the bridge builder craft, because as an orchestra conductor, I can say you are good, you have a good voice, or you can play the instrument, but you're not. Yes, I don't need you. But if you are a bridge builder, you don't have this comfort, because otherwise there is no bridge. Yes. You should embrace everything and everybody to that work. So, and even now we have what is new in our border work, that we have a day in the year calendar, which is the day of the bridge. And one time a year, we mobilized all the community to celebrate or to prepare for the whole year, but at the end to celebrate the bridge which don't belong to anybody, any Lithuanian, Polish, old believers, Protestant or Orthodox group. But this is a bridge belonging to everybody. It is August 22nd and you are invited, feel invited to come to Sejmy, to our borderland and be part of this bridging work. We can do it together. This is just an invitation, but this is also just to say you about the main focus of our work after all this experience we gained after 25 years of our work. Thank you.